Welcome students. In the previous class, we had studied about the private and public limited companies in the venture of joint stock companies. And now we shall be having a comparison between these private and public limited companies, how they work and what are the distinct features they are having. So let us start with the comparison features. The first one is the membership. The private limited companies are open only to the private members, but the public limited companies are open to general public. In case of private limited company, the range of membership lies from 2 to 50, that is 2 is the minimum and 50 is the maximum. But in case of public limited companies, the minimum is at least 7%, but for maximum we are having no limit, that is infinite number of members can be there. Now the election of directors is not required in case of private limited company, it is by the mutual consent, but for public limited it is required. The resale of shares is not possible for a private company, but in case of a public company the shares can be resaled. Audit of the accounts. There is no legal binding for audit of private companies, but public companies have a strict legal obligation of audit of financial statements. Now the minimum capital can be anything in case of private companies. They can be started with a minimum amount of whatever they want, but for a public company they at least required a limited amount of money to start the venture, as their structure house is quite big. Now the next is the distinction features of partnership and joint stock company. Here we will differentiate between a partnership firm and a joint stock company. How joint stock companies are different from partnership firm. In a previous class we had differentiated the partnership firm from the sole proprietorship. Now we will differentiate the partnership firm from joint stock company. Number one, the liability of members is limited in case of partnership firm, but in case of joint stock company the liability is limited to the value of the shares only, value of shares. The range is 2 to 20 in case of partnership firm, that is the minimum 2 and maximum 20 persons can be constituted for a partnership firm, but for a joint stock company the range is extended to 50, that is a minimum of 2 and a maximum of 50 persons. Now a partnership firm has no separate legal identity. It means the partners and the firm are considered as a singular firm, but in case of joint stock company the company is having a separate legal existence. For a partnership the capital is limited, but for a joint stock company the large amount of capital is required. Partnership firm is managed by partners and a joint stock company is managed by board of directors which are elected. The shares are not transferable in case of partnership firm, but transferable in case of joint stock company. Partnership firm is having a short life, where a joint stock company is having permanent existence. It can exist because the responsibilities and duties are generally transferred from one person to other in case of board of directors. Now a partnership firm has simple legal procedure to be followed, whereas a joint stock company has a very complex structure of legal procedures. It is having a complex structure of legal procedures. The smooth and efficient management is difficult in case of partnership firm, whereas a joint stock company, being a flexible in nature, can be efficiently and smoothly managed. Partnership firm is governed by Partnership Act 1932, whereas the joint stock company is governed by Indian Companies Act 1956. Now, the last form of business organization is cooperative society. Cooperative society. What is a cooperative society? It is a voluntary association of people or business to achieve an economic goal with social perspective. Now, here are few points which you will have to remember. A cooperative society, number one, it is a voluntary form of organization. The next, they have to achieve a common economic goal. The people which are volunteering to form a cooperative society has to achieve a common economic goal. That means they are having some common economic goal. And the third and the most major one is the social service or the social perspective. They have to serve society in some manner. Now, the characteristics, as I had already mentioned, it is a voluntary organization. A minimum membership requirement is 10 and maximum no limit. Now, we shall revise once again. In case of sole proprietorship, the owners are 1. For partnership firm, it is 2 to 20. For a joint stock company, it is 2 to 50, and for a cooperative society, it is 10 to no limit. It is 10 to no limit. Now, 2 to 50 is in case of private company, I mentioned. Registration of cooperatives is must under Cooperative Societies Act. After the registration, it enjoys certain privileges of a joint stock companies also. It is somewhat similar in case of joint stock company. Now, what are the various advantages and disadvantages of cooperative society? Number one, easy formation. Formation is very, people will have to volunteer. The members who want to form, they will have to volunteer first. So, it is as per the needs and desires of people. Next is limited liability. Then comes stability. These are quite stable. Then a democratic management. It is a unique feature of cooperatives. Then state assistance. The idea of cooperatives comes under the central government, in which usually the powers are distributed to state and the shareholdings are respective, such as the 50% is from the central government, 30% from state government, and 20% by the people who are volunteering. So, we can say the liability is limited. This is just an example. Don't consider to be a rule of the government. It is just an example. What are the disadvantages? Possibility of conflict, because in a democratic form of management, there can be conflicts. Long decision making powers and not enough capital. Undoubtedly, the state and central government usually support such organizations, but the capital for the initial working is usually invested by the members of the company. So, if the capital is not generated, the company will lose its existence. So, student, it was all for the chapter of forms of business organization. In this chapter, we had understood the basic concepts regarding the various forms of organization. These were, the first form of business organization was sole proprietorship. What is a sole proprietorship? It is managed by a single owner. So, the next one was a partnership firm. What is a partnership firm? A partnership firm usually works by the mutual concept of 2 to 20 partners. It is a partnership. It includes 2 to 20 persons. Every person is having limited liabilities. Now, the next one is, the third one is joint stock companies. What are the joint stock companies? The joint stock company, these are of two types. A is private and B is public. Private usually consists of 2 to 50 members and no maximum limit. No maximum limit. Now, the last one was cooperative societies. Sometimes in the examination, the cooperative society comes in short questions. So, don't go for its length. It is an important question from examination point of view. The fourth one is cooperatives. Cooperatives. These are having maximum of no limit, 10 to infinity. Number of persons can be any for maximum. The cooperatives, they generally come under government policies or government assistance and are having a democratic management, which is not present in above mentioned forms of business organization. So, students, it was all for the various types of forms of organization, business organization. So, revise them. You can take help from the textbook also to get more content and watch the videos 2 or 3 times to understand the concept. It is quite important. So, the chapter is finished and now you must revise, and we shall be having a test in a short duration of it. Thank you.